Assalamu alaikum. My name is Samir Rahman and I am a creative artist and designer specializing in Arabic calligraphy. I was fortunate enough to be able to donate this piece for the Cambridge Mosque Project. And the name of this piece is Muhammad. I want to create a piece which is in praise of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam using this verse, which is إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. In the Quran, it's mentioned that Allah and the angels, they send salutations upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I did want to stick with square kufic mainly because of the method I'm using, the technique of using veneers and parquetry, because we use chisels to hand cut each of the shapes and each piece. The reason I chose this final design is mainly because of the dome shape at the top. And the dome is a very strong Islamic symbol. It represents the sort of connection between heaven and earth. The geometry itself is a combination of 12-fold and 8-fold. I've used three different woods. You have the laurel burr, which is the very lighter color wood. You've got all the little five-pointed stars. And the darker wood after that is the eucalyptus burr. But the center star is done in the Mavingu wood, which is also the same wood that I used for the calligraphy. So in calligraphy, one of the first concepts you learn is the nukta. The nukta is the foundation of Arabic calligraphy. If you look at all the other pieces within the geometry that are from the same wood, it gives you the shape of the nukta. And at the heart of this nukta, you have this 12-pointed star. Now, a 12-pointed star is basically three nuktas overlapping each other. So, initial stage, applying the pieces onto the top part, I used gum Arabic. And once all the pieces are put into place, the next stage is flipping the design onto the wood. So with this piece, it took me roughly about 50 hours in total. Someone can see the final result and they can appreciate it, but they'd never truly understand the sort of journey you went through getting there. And I think that's the one personal attachment you keep with your piece.